Could be a bit of a cultural shift.
And can I introduce you also to Anthony Duffy?
Good morning.
Good morning.
And these are our students, a mix of students who bring the from all the different levels of fine art photography. And I think they've all put some work up and are happy to chat. And there's a coffee, we'd love a coffee.
Has everybody seen the show at the art gallery?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Who liked it most?
So you're welcome to take a seat or wander around, which are six dress.
Should I go through this way or go through the work?
Yeah, that would be nice.
Okay. How do I feel like what?
Your work interacts and interplays against them. How do you feel like the advancements?
It's all sort of part of one big world. You know, it used to be not too many years ago that there would be a local feeling to somebody's work, and now it's all international because of communications and the internet, and it's all like one big fabric.
Yeah.
One.
And because obviously the fabric of communication has changed, it means that art in itself has changed. Has it changed the way that you express yourself within your images, from foreground, background, text and image? Do you use communication and internet more, or computers?
I don't know, it's just one big puzzle to me. I don't try to understand it, but it's, and I'm generally influenced just by about everything, and there's nothing that I don't that I see that I'm not some way influenced by. So it's hard to find, you know, exactly what the influences are, but it's like everything.
Do you still find that the work that you make is very manual? You do it by hand, constantly still, and you don't use technology so much?
Yeah, things are still manual, believe it or not. And I know that they'll be making paintings out of super titanium digital reproductions, and you know, there'll be new surprises in the world in the next few years. But who knows? I mean, maybe that'll be something that we're meant to do as robots.
Ed, do you think we should sit down so everybody can hear what you're saying?
Fine. originally, I thought I wanted to be a sign painter, and I liked lettering with the brush, and that. And so, art school was next, and then I was introduced to photography, and that seemed to have some answer for me. And then I was combining the two, and then I fell in with the wrong crowd, and the wrong crowd was the fine arts. And that was the beginning of the end.
Who were they? Who were these people?
They were the bohemians of the school. It's just people that didn't have a commercial agenda, and didn't have a direct course from A to B. They wanted to stay at A and swim around in A and stay there for a while, and it seemed like what they were doing was on the right track. So then it led to oil painting, and then I started going to museums later on and appreciating things that were pictures, you know, just pictures of any kind, no matter where they were, trying to look at them like they didn't deserve to be examined that intensely, but that they should be appreciated for what they are, which was pictures, whether they're a painting in a museum or a photograph in a newspaper.
So, is there any particular photographer that you admire yourself or that you inspire with?
Well, there's a photographer, Robert Frank, and another, Walker Evans, that, and I know that Robert Frank was Swiss and grew up in Europe, and he came to America and did this book called The Americans, which you might know, and I think it stunned a lot of Americans, because for someone to come from another land and see their life like they saw it, and bring things out in the open that you never expected to be there, and so it was disarming, you know. It was like surprising to see these images of America.
So do you think Robert Frank fulfilled the giving a good message, the right message of America, with just because he just produced the one book, was it?
Well, I think he really hit it on the head with that book, and then he went on to do more private-oriented, cerebral kind of images that didn't particularly have that much to do with America, but my initial introduction to him was through that book called The Americans. Yeah. And then Walker Evans was another kind of photographer who covered also America and the poor side of America, the South, and during the 1920s, 30s, 40s, like that.
And that was very influential to you in your student coming for the photographic days.
Oh, like what?
That was very influential to you.
I think so, and there's something that I've always appreciated with black and white photography and also black and white movies. I have a leaning towards that, and I've always liked that. So I say, why Technicolor? Why do you need it?
Is there anything that triggers your choice of colour in relation to the words you use? Is it some of it's obvious, but is the use of the choice of colour intuitive, or is it directly related to something that you've influenced by or?
Color-wise, no, and I've never been intrigued with the science of color particularly. And I have a slight red-green color deficiency, so I'm seeing things different than a lot of people. And it's never been that much of an issue to me. And I've also felt like the initial making of a work of art can be gathered together by using all these tools and methods, and sometimes off-the-shelf colors can do the job. And so torturing yourself over the concept of color can be worthwhile, I guess, if it helps you, but at the same time, I'm not sure.
Quick question actually about scale of your paintings. Is there any particular...
Which paintings?
Well, your paintings in general actually. Is there any real reason for you painting at the scale that you do? And are you happy, is it like a happy size you like working at?
Size is always, something that's more curious than size is the fact that we tend to orient ourselves first with something that's rectangular, with straight sides and straight sides top and bottom, and they usually match up with one another or parallel. You might, if you're facing that kind of question, you might ask yourself, well, why isn't the shape of this thing wiggly instead of square like this? Look, you look around the room and all these works are square, and the world has adapted to that, and I find that to be rather curious, that it's so easy to surrender to this idea of a rectangle or a square or a circle or something that's more classical than something that is wild and crazy. And I also approach making a picture without even thinking of it, that this thing is going to be rectangular or square.
Is there anything that you thought, I've got to see this if I'm coming to England?
Oh yeah. I just saw a painting show by George Kondo, and I know his work, and I was excited to see that. He's an American, but it knows no national boundaries. I don't have any particular thoughts about. If you're speaking of London, when I go there, there's always something to see, and it comes from all over the world, and from every discipline, and so it's just it's fortunate for us to be able to. See all this art.
Do you get to visit art schools in America very often?
I haven't done that since 1970 when I taught class at UCLA, and I kind of resented not being in my studio. But I also found out that the students that were most skeptical of what I had to say usually turn out to be the best students. So it's a healthy thing to be skeptical.
Too late now.
do you store the Beach Boys lyrics? And because you were of that era, all your books were juxtaposed to lyrics from the Beach Boys. And I think everybody looking at that show, I came out and thought, I wonder if Ed Ruscha ever liked Beach Boys.
Yeah.
And I can ask you that question.
I guess I like the spirit of it, and you can hear a couple of bars of their music, and you can kind of conjure up images of Southern California beach style surfers, imagery like that, and it's got sort of like a little niche in your thinking, and it'll always be there probably. But then there's also, you know, there'll be new Beach Boys, whoever they might be.
Do you feel your work has changed as the world's changed?
A little bit. I've gone through waves of feeling different about the world, and somehow it comes out in my work.
Your work's very American-based. But through travelling in that, do you pick up influences from other countries that might trigger a new style of painting?
I visited this country in 1961, and I didn't know about American music until I came here. And the British had, the record stores that you would go to, were filled with American music, and music that we didn't really see that much of in America. I mean, it was blues music from the South, and this forgotten music was revered by the British, and so I learned a lot about my country just by coming here.
Did you listen to the music when you were?
What's that?
When you were, did you listen to music?
Do I listen? Sometimes not, and I like it. I like silence. It's good to have nothing, but don't listen to anything. And then other times I'll listen. Usually when I'm driving in the car, I'll listen to music. And I listen more when I'm driving in the car than I do when I'm in my studio.
Can you tell us a bit about your studio? Is it are you a one-person painter, or do you have lots of assistants?
I have assistants from time to time, and I do have assistants, and but finally I can't run a factory, I'll tell you that. And I can't have more than three or four people around me, because then it's I'm addressing a different subject than what I should be addressing, which is just to kind of like turn back and have a dialogue with myself.
I was going to ask, which piece of work was it that took you 3 or 4 years to work on?
Oh, which what?
Which piece of work was it that took you that period of time to work on? The one that took three years to complete?
That painting was called the Los Angeles County Museum of Art on Fire. So it was like an aerial picture of the way the museum looked like in 1965, and it's a considerably different building today, and then I had the thing on fire, and I worked on it for like 3.5 years or something, and so it was different than anything I've done, because I didn't focus my full-time attention on that. I would drop it and then go back to it.
Lovely. Well, thank you very, very much for coming in today. It's been a real, real pleasure for everybody.
Ask a ferry on Tuesday.
Yeah.
Okay.
she's the in charge of all these things.
Wondering.